Hello everybody and welcome to this new video. Yes, it's kind of a review of electric racing car. Yes, basically it is a Scalextric game that has been put on the Xbox Marketplace for 69p, or if you're in America, close to $1. As you can see with the free camera, you can literally see what I've been doing on the 16th of April when I actually bought this game. Yes, I played through it on that night. Just played most of it, and I've enjoyed so far. Obviously, this is one of the great things you can do. You can actually build your own circuit. As you can see, I'm just showing you what I've done. And obviously, that is not all. You can play challenge mode or split screen. If you have a friend, you can play with them. Also, you can do free mode. You can see I'm going through some of the things that I've done, and obviously the controls are pretty simple. A or the right trigger to be the accelerator, and obviously the brake is the X and the left trigger. As you can see here, as the lights go out and away we go. Music guide has been turned off from this game due to the fact that we have, obviously, because of content ID, these lot could actually, I could get ripped for it. So all I've got is the engine noise from the cars. That you just, as you can just see, if you go too fast, you can literally take the car off, as you can see plenty of times I'm doing it. It's all about precision, like in real life. When you do Scalextric in real life, you've got to be firm but careful with how you drive. So if you without that skill, you won't do well. As you can see, the fastest lap at the moment is a 16.116. Obviously, if you get into a certain groove, as you can see, this is on medium. I haven't gone up to hard yet, so I don't know how hard they are, but easy I can do. Medium, if I'm in the groove, I can beat them. And if you want to, each track has to have an odd amount of crossroads. So when you come up to lap them, which I have done, which I did do last night, I will admit it was awful doing that, but yeah, you have to knock them off to overtake them. Obviously, if you're lapping them for the second time, you're on opposite sides, so it won't affect you. You just gotta get it in the right moment to overtake. You see that I've knocked him off there? Basically, you gotta do that to lap them, or you literally are just doing slow lap times right behind them, which is very annoying. Also, when you fall off, you can do that tactic of annoying them. But yeah, when you get to the crossroads on them, you have to be ahead to make very far ahead to make sure you don't crash off like that. But yeah, overall, the way the game's made is pretty good actually. Obviously, the turns you can get. Obviously, there's no height like you can get with real Scalextric, so you literally cannot cross over. Which is a shame. It's something I'd like to see in a future development of this game. As you can see now, I'm literally having a mess around on my oval track, which I'm only going to do two laps. I did try and pull down back down to medium for this one, but obviously I missed it and easy. But obviously, yeah. It's a good game to play, and I'm fully enjoying playing it, to be fair. I know PGUK, my network partners, do reviews, and yeah, they do all the big titles. And I just thought, whilst I was waiting for Saints Row 4, which is available currently on Xbox Live, if you've got Xbox Live membership, not the free one, the gold version, you can get Saints Row 4 for free until the end of April. And obviously there's Sunset Overdrive on Xbox One if you want that. I've already got that ready for when I do make the upgrade from Xbox 360 to Xbox One. When I do that, I do not know, but anyway, as you can see, I've just messed about. There's so much you can do on this. It's unbelievable. The amount of imagination you can make for these is unbelievable. You see, I'm just literally, I know I've, by the looks of it, I actually thought, yeah, I could still, because you can see, I go quick and slow down, then go speeding up again, and come back. see me, I'm coming back. I'm thinking, yes, I'm back in it. Through this bit, I'm literally net almost right behind him. Then I do that. Like, you get your hopes up, and then you do that, hoping to knock him off to give you a chance to get back. And then, after that corner, that was it. So I just decided, you know what, if I'm going to fall off, I'm going to fall off. I don't care. I've lost the race. But as I say, this isn't just a track you can make. You can make any track. I could probably build F1 tracks, which I probably will do a series on, guys, and do a couple of races round. And I thought to myself, you know what, stuff it, I'm having another race. I'm winning this. I'm not losing on this track. And I do that. So yeah, guys, this is a pretty good game, and I quit because I had enough of it. But as I say, as you can see, you can make any circuit, literally any circuit, with the tools that this has, making tracks, as you can see in a minute. Literally, the possibilities are endless on this game. You see, up the top, you got A to place, X to change the section, LT and RT choose the bend, and obviously you've got the left and right on the D-pad that can change the length of the actual thing. Obviously you've got Y to auto-adjust. Auto-adjust everything. Obviously I didn't know I was right near the end, because the actual thing isn't coming through on the thing. On the actual... when I was playing it, for some reason the capture software won't allow me to listen to it. So I think, oh yeah, I'm done, but then you say you have to have odd things. So I try and save it here. Try it on number crossroad sections. So basically, I need at least one on each one, and then an extra one to make it odd. You'll see me just like changing it now. Just keep pressing in and X to change the section. Just choose places where I can do them. Let's see, in this one I get two. There's two on that one, but obviously you don't see it, and obviously you can see me saving it as oval. But as I say, guys, I will attempt to make every single F1 track on the 2015 calendar on in this series. So I have a load of tracks. We see on the side, I'm gonna go fallout system. Medium with me having a car advantage, the power. But as I say, guys, this game is immense. I love it, and it's something I would play a lot longer if you could change the view. Which is back. Select is changing the view, and yeah. So this is just a basic track I've just made. I've just made a rectangle oval. You can, you saw me make that weird track. Obviously for me, I don't have all the stuff that you have in the challenge mode where you can put indie bit of bits inside it just yet. But yeah, it is pretty good. Definitely worth the 69p I paid for it. And it's something I want to bring to the channel. As you can see, I just came second in that one. Just behind, but yeah, it's a good game to play. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. I played till about 10 o'clock last night after buying it. Then from 10 till 11 I played a bit Saints Row finishing off that, but I think it was like 7 while 10 I was on this game, and I was just going through it. Tweaking the trigger, right trigger, just to get the right amount of speed. But yeah, anyway, if I was going to rate this, guys, I rate this an 8 out of 10. There's some improvements, like obviously I'm showing split screen, obviously I ain't got an extra control, so I can't do that. But yeah, 9 out of 10. 8 out of 10, it needs to be able to have the crossroads on. Apart from that, it's pretty good. I'm going to end the video now. Like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you all soon. Goodbye.